State volcanologists warn Mayon volcano could continue rumbling for months. This means thousands of residents will have to remain in evacuation centers. Mayon is currently under alert level 3.
Based on our previous experiences, this activity may persist for a few months. Kapag violent naman yung eruption niya, this would probably just take a few days to weeks. Pero kapag ganitong mabagal, it will probably take several months. Katulad ng 2018 eruption natin from January to March. And then yung 2014, ganun din, almost the same number of months.
The Albay Provincial Agriculture Office has begun buying produce from farmers inside the 6-kilometer permanent danger zone. This initiative helps the farmers reduce losses, while purchased goods will be used to feed evacuated residents. Farmers, however, can only harvest their crops as long as authorities allow them to enter the 6-kilometer permanent danger zone.
Ang intention po namin dito is to buy them at prices na talagang advantageous to the government at farm gate prices. Hindi naman po malulugi mag-ibenta nito and at the same time, tayo naman po, hindi rin tayo masyadong mamahalan.
Maraming salamat po sa APAW na kami natulungan at na ibenta pa itong ano namin, burukto.
Farmers who were allowed to enter the danger zone in this part of Albay have come up with a traditional warning system to alert others of danger. Farmers say they would shout loud enough to inform others they're out in the field or warn them to immediately evacuate if Mayon acts up.
Nabaraba na kami pag nagputok ng Mayon.
Sisigaw.
Na ano yan, tanda na baraba na tayo kasi pumutok na yung bulkan.
In the meantime, evacuees in this temporary shelter in Daraga are complaining of lack of drinking water and not enough food supply. Some also claim displaced residents who have a home near the relocation site are not given priority for relief assistance.
Sa ngayon po sir, ang kakulangan dito ng evacuation, yung pagkain. Dahil isang bis pa lang nagbigay yung distribulo din ng mga repack. Ngayon po, ang kakulangan dito, tubig dahil na inumin.
Ang priority daw po kasi nila yung walang bahay po sa anislag. Kaya medyo maano po, kaya pag may mga sobra-sobra na lang po, binibigyan na lang po namin, share-share na lang.
Albay Governor Edsel Greco Lagman, however, says all evacuees will be given aid, including those living with their relatives.
Hindi naman po ito pabigat sa mga kukup-kup sa kanilang mga kamag-anak nila dahil they are still considered as evacuees. Meaning to say, meron pa rin silang daily rationing of food.
Lagman also gave his assurance food will not be a problem since the Social Welfare Department has turned over food packs enough for 15 days. Still in Daraga, face-to-face classes in Gabawan Elementary School will resume Wednesday. Classes will be divided into two shifts to avoid congestion. Various facilities will be used as temporary classrooms, including chapels, covered courts, and village halls.
Siguradong magiging siksikan po yung klase nila. Kasi yung ibang room po o ibang nagagamitin is medyo maliit lang.
For now, state volcanologists say there's no reason to raise the alert level.
Masasabi natin na although nag-aalburuto ang Mayon Volcano, stable pa yung lagay niya. Ibig sabihin, hindi naman nagbabago.
Jose Carretero, ABS-CBN News.